was never about, I guess, being the biggest or necessarily being the most craziest or the freakiest in some portions, putting together a complete physique that would, you know, outlive me in a legacy.
Hi, this is Peter McGough of Muscular Development. I'm here with Brandon Curry, a bodybuilder who I greatly admire, who's got a tremendous physique and a tremendous shape. Brandon, just touch on for us, what are your next competitive plans? Is there anything on the horizon for you?
Yeah, I plan to compete early. You know, I've been on break since the Arnold last year. So I plan on jumping into the Arnold this year, Australia, Brazil, you know, just getting busy this year because I've had plenty of rest, fresh wheels, ready to go.
And do you think you can improve on your past showings? I mean, you're moving forward?
Oh, of course. Have some time to get some things together, regroup, reset. I definitely have improved, had a chance to improve on some things, really going to do the work and not really have to diet, break myself down over the past season, so.
And you're one of the few bodybuilders, I hate to say this, that you're a real family man. Things are about family. Your wife, Brandy, and is it three children you have now?
Four.
Well, he's prolific. So it's all repetition with bodybuilding in every aspect of life. So, Brandon, tell us how important family life is to you.
Oh, man, it's first and foremost. I mean, you are your legacy that you leave behind. And, you know, so if I could groom, especially my young men that I got coming up, as to be good young men in society and kind of carry on the name in a positive light, I mean, that's what, you know, I feel I'm put here to do. So family first, father first, and then setting a good example in what I do and giving the best I can in this industry is next, so.
Your transition into bodybuilding was a bit different from most guys. It's almost like there was no men's physique in those days, but you were a model, weren't you, for supplement companies and other even fashion houses. You had a good physique, but it wasn't a competitive bodybuilding physique. Tell me how that changed. What age were you when that happened?
Well, I guess I was in my early 20s when I was appearing in fitness muscle magazines. And I showed up to a shoot when I was getting ready for, I guess, USA's in 2007. And before that, I guess in 2006, I had competed as a bodybuilder, but in junior nationals. So I was a light heavyweight then. So I wasn't really, really small, but I wasn't, I still could fit the fitness modeling profile. Once I showed up for 2007 for a photo shoot in LA, they looked at me and says, Brandon, this will be your last shoot for this particular fitness magazine. And it looks like you'd be moving to the bodybuilding branch of the magazine. And I thought to myself, I just can't move to those bodybuilding magazines. You normally have to be a professional bodybuilder to appear in those magazines. Sure enough, I got a contract. I got a bodybuilding publishing contract the next year at my first USA. So definitely I had put on a certain amount of size that kind of took me out of the profile of the fitness model. I just like to train, and I did love bodybuilding, but modeling was something that I fit into, so I just kind of did that as in the meantime, I guess you say.
So what was the drive? Was the drive to get as big and or as refined as you could get? You know, you won the USA's, 2008, was it?
Yes, sir.
So, and that was, what sort of body weight were you there? And how, at that point, close were you to where you wanted to be?
Well, I was 217, I guess, there, and I had no expectations of what I could really do in the sport. Size, playing the size game and being as big as possible was also not a goal, because that's not what I looked up to when I looked at the sport. I looked at all the quality physiques, the guys that were put together. The guys kind of fit my profile of body type, you know, the Sean Rays, the Flex Wheelers, and I wanted to emulate what I thought would be a piece of art. A work of art, something I could really, be proud of and just use my genetics to their potential. So, you know, it was never about, being the biggest or necessarily being the most craziest or the freakiest in some portion. It's putting together a complete physique that would, outlive me in a legacy. So,
I mean, you know, your pro career, you've had some good days, you've had some not so good days, you won in Brazil, and people have leveled against you unfairly in a way, because this shows what a crazy sport we are. Oh, Brandon's not prepared to gamble like the other guys. But I mean, obviously you've explained your mindset isn't like...
Yeah, I mean, it's not really about the gamble. I mean, there's certain things that I guess slow the process, and I've been following certain leadership over the years as well, just doing what I've been told. But, you know, as you get older, you get wiser, you learn more about the industry, and you learn more about what things take. And I'm at a place now where I'm prepared to, you know, to make the proper decisions. I got a family behind me that I have to definitely support. So, I mean, it's about moving forward. It's about reaching greater peaks in my career. So I'm willing to carry this out. I have every intention on being a very competitive Olympian. So, I mean, it's not like I'm slacking and lackadaisical about anything. I really care about the sport. But I want to present something that, you know, the industry will be proud of, as well as the people that support me.
I've often commented on your, what I call your signature pose. I don't know what it is, where you do the double biceps and then you cock to the side. Did you get that pose? I mean, it's real classic. But that's like back in the day and nobody does it. Where did you get it from, or did it come from your head? Because it really, you look great in the standard pose, then you go to the left and it looks even better.
It's almost like a natural tendency. When you do look at those classic pictures of the guys that use their hip swivel, it's like, first when you're learning how to bodybuild, you emulate those things. And you just kind of find that groove. What feels good to you, you kind of use it. And it's always felt good to me. I felt seeing guys in that pose is something I could emulate, and I just use that. If you got weapons, you know, it's best to use them in sport.
So going into 2015, tell us what sort of a physique we should expect, improvements, anything that's different. What's the road for you?
Well, you know, I'm always going to try to bring a more complete package. We're working on bringing in density, more hardness in my physique, more maturity, of course, will be there because of the training I've been able to put in during this break in this season. But much more size, just more complete package. I'm not looking to be a totally different body. That's not realistic for the longevity of my career. But I'm looking to make the improvements to where, you know, when you look at me on stage, you say he's creeping up, he's making progress. And you know, I just let the cards fall where they may. I don't have a crystal ball, and I'm not a prophet. So I'm just going to go out and do the best I can this season. And, you know, hopefully that turns in my favor.
Brandon, I'd just like to thank you for your time and your friendship over the years. And, you know, really respect you as a family man who's very well grounded and got proper values. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.